We started when I was working with the company, right? So I worked for some time as an IT consultant for some companies where when I found like there are 4 or 5 customers already onboarded. We have outsourced our finance like department to a company who is handling our finances, like where like accounting has been done by their team and any kind of compliance is required, they are handling our compliance itself. Right now we have around like 215 clients working with us. So we are targeting by 2024, more than 600 plus customers should be like working with us and where we have provided our services.
Hello sir, thank you for joining today. I'm Namrata and I'll be taking your interview. But before the interview begins, would you like to introduce yourself to the audience?
Definitely, Namrata. Good morning, Namrata and our startup clients, viewers on YouTube. My name is Sumit Jain and my company name is Advice and Consulting Services Private Limited. We are the team of IT consultants where we provide solution to cybersecurity services and with the name of Threat Rescue, which is one of the flagship model we have.
All right. So tell me something about your startup. How did you come up with the idea?
So idea jumps on me when I see there is so many gaps when we consider SME and SMB class customers. There is a gap of cybersecurity awareness, IT security implementations. People are not very, very much aware about the cybersecurity threats into the company. So we thought to start a company where we can provide a cybersecurity services to our customers into SME and SMB class customers, and where we can provide them awareness trainings as well as various other services to them.
All right. So were there any difficulties or challenges you had faced in the beginning?
We started when I was working with the company, right? So I worked for some time as an IT consultant for some companies where when I found like there are 4 or 5 customers already onboarded in our name. So I left the job and started my company dedicatedly. And there was some issue in starting, like finance was the one of the concern where we need to invest capital to like purchasing hardwares. And like it's an upfront investment because our company was new. So it was an upfront investment from our side, which we need to take. So we tried to do something like by investing ourselves like from the same accounts and other part of it. So hopefully like that, the experience was good. The second concern was like team management, like hiring a good team for the company is always a concern for any startup. So we try to figure out somehow and we provided we have a good team to consider good cybersecurity services for any enterprise class customers.
All right. Now, if you had to explain your business model to someone who has very limited knowledge about it, how would you do that?
So we are very straightforward business model. We are service oriented like company. We are working into a model of system integration where we provide services as well as solution both. There are companies in the market who are either providing only the services or providing solutions. So we are the company who is providing a services for cybersecurity as well as the solution whenever we like our engineers are recommending any kind of threats to the company and we provide solution to them. So that's a business model we are following as of now.
Okay. Now, if you had to list down all your services or solutions, how do you do that?
So we start with a cybersecurity model as a service where we try to figure out any kind of threats in the existing setup or existing architecture in your company. So accordingly, as per my cybersecurity expert recommended us few solution to be implemented. So we provide them a solution. It can be starting from a firewall, and antivirus, backup solutions, cloud security, these kind of solutions which we have. And email security is one of the things which is very near to my heart, and I provide this kind of a solution to any customer. We say for ourselves and for our team, there is no challenge in email security which we cannot mitigate. We can mitigate any kind of challenges that people are facing in emails.
All right.
So that's part of it.
All right. Now, who are your target customers? Is this just a B2B model or is there some layer of it? How do you?
It's a B2B model. Yeah, it's a B2B model. We are targeting a specific class of customer in SME and SMB class. Like if I say on the basis of number of users or number of internet employees, we start with anytime like 50 users in a company, it goes up to 3,000 users. We have 200 plus customers as of now, and we are catering 50 users customers as well as 3,000 users customers for these kind of services which we have.
All right. Now, you would also be aware that similar kind of businesses provide similar kind of services that you do. So why should the businesses choose and go for your services and not somebody else's?
Yeah, definitely. Like there are so many companies working in the same space. If I talk about in Delhi, there are more than 5,000 companies running into this particular space. So we have an experience of 200 plus customers where we have provided our services. And these are limited to like SME and SME class customers, right? We are not targeting the higher enterprise class customers having 4,000 users, 5,000 users, because these kind of companies are looking for like big system integrators like HCL, Wipro kind of companies. So we are limited in those kind of services, and we provide best of the services to these two sectors of the companies, right? So we are not very vertical agnostic, like any vertical, every vertical is customer to us, as far as they are like happy to work with us and we are happy to give them our services with 100% dedication.
You are providing a particular kind of service to customers. I want to know from you, what are the services you require on to run your business efficiently?
So generally we have outsourced our finance like department to a company who is handling our finances, like where like accounting has been done by their team, and any kind of compliance is required, they are handling our compliance itself. So we are happy to outsource the particular department where we are not having the expertise, right? That's the one thing. Then other part is marketing part of it, which we are not doing dedicatedly for ourselves. We have hired a team on like quarterly basis, right, on retention model. So we provide them some kind of project related to our services so that they can do a marketing. So these are the two departments we generally outsource to some other companies so that we can focus on our business dedicated.
Now, when choosing vendors or say outsourcing partners, what are the kind of parameters you judge them before taking them on board?
So we, like, first we take on, like, is there any kind of a referral which we are getting from, like, if somebody has referred those companies to us, right? So this is one of the criteria. We don't go for a company which is very new to us. We are not known to the owners or the teams which we are working. So we try to figure out within the friend circle, within the business circle, if they are providing the same services to them. So we are much more depending on the referral part of it, where like people can refer us, or friends or business partners can refer us, or for certain companies, for certain services which we can like outsource to any company or startup.
Now, if somebody wants to join your team and become a part of your company, what are the kind of benefits that person is going to get, like the work culture and the skills? Is that person going to take from your organization?
So during this pandemic times, and like if I say for the technical team, so we have our technical team who is working from home for last 18 months, right? So we are not asking them to come to office, because technical thing can be managed by working from home. Like they need to give them support, they can give them like any kind of requirement if customer is asking, so they can handle from home as well. We are just asking our sales team to coming to office, because in the sales culture, if the people are not meeting, so we cannot like have a fruitful discussion to generate business out of it. So we are asking sales team to coming to office. If a new person wants to join our company, so there is immense like scope for learning, right? Because we are a startup, we are not very big company where there is so much roles available and so much like policies are there. We are very open culture company where anybody and everybody is having a business mindset, right? If you are getting business for us, you will be part of an incentive, right? It can be accountant, it can be any technical person, it can be like any other person who is working for us. So this, there is very open culture. If somebody wants to join, he will be able to learn so many things with us, because we are not limited to a single product line. We have a different product line, different services in every part of technology. So that's the beauty of our company if they join.
Okay. Now, talking about the future of the company, what are the long-term goals you have planned?
So right now we have around like 215 clients working with us. So we are targeting by 2024, more than 600 plus customers should be like working with us and where we have provided our services. So definitely like there is some gap happening as of now, because due to the pandemic, the things are getting slowed down. But hopefully like by this month, and people will start figuring out the new things from us, and they will like get more services from our side. So definitely like 600 plus is our target for 2024.
Okay. Now, you would agree to this fact that whenever a startup wants to grow and expand, having a steady source of funds plays a really crucial role in it. So if you could just walk me through the funding scenario of your company, like have you taken funds previously, or are you willing to in the near future? How is it working for you?
So we are totally bootstrapped. Like we are working from like a customer funding scenario where our customers are always a funder for us. So we have not taken any kind of funding from anybody till date, and it has been more than 6 years now. So we are open to funding. Like if somebody wants to join and wants to work on the basis of funding, we are okay. And if they are working, or like we have a gap in like a technology person who can handle the whole business as a business generation point of view. So definitely we can look at the part where whenever any good technology person wants to join our company with funding against equity, definitely we can discuss on it.
All right. Now, lastly, what are your thoughts on startup loans?
Definitely great job you people are doing. Like I've joined your company as a viewer, and for last 2-3 months, I'm following Mr. Shirish for last 2-3 months on LinkedIn, and like he's doing fantastic job for founders and aspiring founders specifically, where you are providing some of the services which is required by any startup to start a company. Generally, founders may aisa hota hai, like they don't start because they don't have any kind of knowledge. The sessions which you do, Ask Me Anything, is a great help for like the new founders and aspiring founders. So definitely you are doing a great job for startup community as well.
Well, thank you for your kind words, sir. It was lovely talking to you.